When we give heat to a body, we give heat to a body at any one part of the body, and the temperature of that part starts increasing. What happens to the other parts of the body? And that we will study today. Whether heat is flowing through the body, does it allow it to move, and what are the methods from molecule to molecule, how the energy, how the heat travels within. And for that, that is known as transfer of heat from one body part to the other body part. This body may be solid, liquid or gas. So first we see a method. It also depends in the method whether the molecules are free to move or they are bound together with such a large force that even heat is not able to move them. Accordingly, the material decide which method should it adopt. What is the natural method? Okay, all methods are adopted by nature according to their forces. So first we will see a method which we call conduction. We have, say for convenience, we take, there is a metal rod here. This is solid. Because this method takes place in the solid. Why it takes place in the solid? The reason is that the molecules are bound together very firmly and they are not allowed to move. They even don't move with energy given by the heat. So what do? They simply, remaining at their place, pass on heat energy to the next particle. That is one molecule. These are the molecules in this. This will give heat energy to the next. This will give heat energy to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next, like this. In this way, heat energy goes on passing and finally it reaches this level. Okay, that is one thing. Other thing is that if I put this one end to a heat reservoir, that is source of heat. Heat reservoir, very simply, I have put a burner here. It is getting heat continuously. Here is water and the water is boiling. What is the temperature? 100 degree, and it will always remain 100 degree. This is one end. Here, I put it in the ice. This. And here is solid ice. And then water is filled up here. It is at a lower temperature. Now we have to understand one thing. What we see here, that this ice is slowly melting. Why the ice should melt? We know that for melting of ice, it requires heat. Who is supplying the heat? This, we put all around it blankets. Make sure that no heat can come from outside. Even then, ice is melting. Very clear, this solid is supplying heat to it. But solid itself has no source of heat. Who is supplying heat to? Ice. Answer, solid is supplying because it is in contact, but from where it's getting the heat? Answer, it is getting heat from here. So if it is getting heat here and it is supplying heat here, that means the heat is traveling through this. And this is what I want to impress, that material has a capacity that it can allow heat to travel within it. This is conduction of heat. conduction. And we see this happens continuously. Continuously means heat is traveling continuously. Just like water is flowing from tank with higher level of water, lower level of water, and it keeps on flowing till both the level become equal. The same thing happens here. The heat keeps on flowing. Heat keeps on flowing till both the level means what? Level of hotness, that is temperature. Till both the temperature become equal. Heat travels through material till temperature of both ends become equal. And if it does not travel, okay, if it does not travel, matter is over, we will say it is not a conductor because it is not conducting the heat. But we are talking about conductors only. Who conducts the heat? That category, leave that. The one which does not conduct the heat. Like blanket or something like that, wood, so many things, we will come to that. But generally, let us say it may be a metal or it may be a non-metal, anything. Some heat will travel. Okay. And that will be known as, this process is conduction. Actually, what do we call conduction? In conduction, this particle is giving heat to it, but the particle does not move. Only heat energy is passing. Particle does not move and the heat is given to neighboring, that is next, molecules. This is the process of conduction. In conduction, heat is passed down to next neighboring molecule without transfer of molecule, without shifting of molecule. Okay, this is conduction. Okay, if the molecule are shifting, that will be other process, convection, that we will study after this. So in conduction, now we are going to the detail. The detail is that how much heat is passing through it. Suppose I put a cross section, a gate here. How much heat is passing through it? How many joule per second? That heat depends upon what? That heat depends upon many features, many physical features. And this we are going to write now. Heat passing through. Any cross section, Q. Q is the heat passing through. This is proportionate to which quantities, which are the quantities which are affecting it. If area is large, more heat will pass. So Q is proportionate to area. Okay, further, Q is proportionate to the temperature difference. Larger is the pressure difference. Larger is the gradient. That is T1 minus T2. T hot, T cold. Whatever, however large is the temperature, fast will be the heat going, just like water. If the level is very different, high, then the water will go very fast. So, heat going per second depends upon change in temperature. Delta T. What is delta T? T hot end minus T cold end. Yes. Then, the longer it is, less will be the quantity of heat moving here. So Q is inversely proportionate to length. Okay. How much heat is going here in 5 seconds? The heat going in 10 seconds will be more. So heat passing is also proportionate to time. So these are features that how much heat is going from here to there. And this we can sum up that Q is proportionate to area into change in temperature divided by length into time. This is how much heat is transferred in time t with temperature difference delta t, area and L. Now, if this is proportionate to it, then what is this equal to? There has to be a constant of proportionality, and that is K. K. So this is A delta T, T divided by L. This is quantity. Now what is this K? K is coefficient of conduction. And it depends upon which features. Let us see. It depends upon which feature. Here we find that K is equal to Q L upon A delta T into time T. So with this we define K. If L is equal to 1 meter, area is equal to 1 meter square, L is equal to 1, area is equal to 1, delta T is equal to 1, small t is equal to 1. What does it mean? There is a rod of length 1, area 1 square meter, temperature difference 1 degree Celsius, and the time given is 1 second. How much heat is passed then? Then the heat passed is equal to K. Then Q is equal to K, or K is equal to Q. This is coefficient of conductivity of any material. Now, this depends upon the nature of the material. How free are the molecules in it? How fast they are giving heat to the next molecule? We can define it. Now, we will write definition of it with help of these figures. So, see here, coefficient of conduction is the heat conducted across 1 meter of distance with 1 square meter of the cross section when the temperature difference is 1 degree Celsius during the time period of 1 second. That much heat is equal to coefficient of conductivity. Right? So that is heat transferred. If more is the coefficient, more heat is transferred. Less is the coefficient, less heat is transferred. So let's write what is coefficient of conductivity. This is our definition of coefficient of conductivity, and its symbol is K. The coefficient of conductivity K of a material, please remember, this is the property of material, not for a given sample or any material. Copper is a material, aluminium is a material, wood is a material, and gases are material. So, coefficient of conductivity of a material is equal to the quantity of heat transferred across unit length of the material having cross section of 1 unit area. The difference between two ends is 1 unit. When the temperature difference between two ends is 1 unit, and during a time period of 1 second. Everything we have made equal to 1, 1, 1, 1. Then heat transfer is equal to K. This is how we write it in the text. So this is conductivity. Now, how much is the conductivity of things around us? And when we are joining more than one particles in series, or we give two parallel paths for heat to travel, then how the conductivity changes. This we will see in the next lecture. Please mind it, the conductivity is just like specific resistance of a material. Conductivity we find it in heat, conductivity we also find in electricity. Electricity, few material are good conductor, few are bad conductor. Similarly, in heat, few are good conductors and few are bad conductors. This we will discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.